fish. This party turned out so great.
Yeah, the food was great. And, oh, well, Hannah seems to be having a great time.
Well, are you guys having fun?
Yeah. Well, you know, even though it's Christmas and we're having this big party, I still feel kind of sad. I don't really know who to talk to about it.
Yeah, I kind of feel the same way, honestly. I mean, I can't even find my favorite top hat.
Oh, I'm sorry, guys. Have you tried praying about it?
Eh, I don't know. Does God really want to hear my feelings?
Yes, God totally wants to hear how you guys are feeling. God loves us and he loves to spend time with us. If God had a dining room table, he would be throwing a dinner party and he'd want us there 24/7 with him. As a matter of fact, through Jesus, God has saved a seat for us at his table. Okay, imagine Thanksgiving dinner, or even some of you might be having Christmas dinner tonight. You know you'll be sitting there, right?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, Christmas dinner is always super fun. Hopefully I'll find my hat before dinner time though.
Well, that's how it is with God. We have a seat at his table always and forever. And we get to eat with him. We get to party, we get to laugh and have fun. Like you said, John, we get to tell stories around the table. It's so fun to just sit with God that we should honestly want to bring friends along. The thing about God's table is that it's expandable. There's no limit to how many people can sit at a time. There's always room and always more seats and always more food.
So you said that God's table is expandable. So like no matter how many people, we can always fit more?
Yeah.
Wow. And does he want us to invite more people?
Indeed, yes. That's part of God's purpose for us.
So like, what does that mean though, God's purpose for us? Like, does God have a purpose for us?
Oh yeah, guys, totally. I mean, if God didn't have purpose for us, we'd just be like free-floating dust particles, you know? Just floating around aimlessly without purpose. But God gives us a purpose. He gave us gifts when we were born.
So what is his purpose for us all?
Well, Jesus said it was to love God and love others. It's like to love God, to be loved by God, and share the good news of Jesus with other people. Like we were saying, you know, God's table can grow bigger and bigger to fit as many people as we want to sit down with him.
Oh.
So wait. When you say that God has a purpose, a plan for my life, does that mean that I have to do whatever he wants me to do? I can't do what I want to do?
That's the beauty of God. Our main purpose is to love God and share his good news, but he also has given us the ability and freedom to dream. He uses our dreams to accomplish our purpose of sharing his good news.
Oh, so like even if the gift God has given me is to sing and I want to be a singer, he can use that to let me sing songs for him. So like I'm getting what I want and he's getting what I want at the same time.
Yes. And it applies to all dreams, not just artistic dreams. He's created all of us so uniquely. So God works through accountants, construction workers, and everyone.
Oh, yeah. So like kind of how we created those vision boards the other day.
If I made a vision board right now, all it would be is just finding my lost hat.
Yeah.
So Trish, you mean like we have our own visions and dreams for our life? And God works through those.
Yeah, and knowing we have a purpose from God even helps us to think of dreams for our lives. It's important to remember that God wants you to be happy. With him by your side, what can't you do? What mountains can't you move? God wants to partner with us and with you guys if we let him and work with him and follow him.
Wow, that's awesome. Is there anything we can tell our friends over at C3 Kids about this?
Yes, actually, C3 Kids. Next week is Dream Sunday. As a church, we're going to pray and believe for the dreams God has put in our hearts. So start thinking about it throughout the week. What dreams do you guys have that you want to see happen this year, 2022? Whoa. What, do you want to see your mom and dad come to church? Do you want to be nicer to your sister or brother? Do you want to see God heal a family member? Do you want to make new friends this year at school? Well, write them down. Pray about them with your grown-up. We'll talk more about it next week.
You know, all this talk about purpose and dreams actually kind of brings to mind a Bible verse. Can I read it?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Cool. I have this Bible that I always keep right next to me at all times. Here you go, let me see. It's Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. I hope God's plan for me involves finding my hat.
I bet it does. Honestly though, we should pray that over ourselves and memorize it. Can you read it again?
Yeah, sure. I mean, I can just do it. For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future.
Oh, I just thought of another good verse for C3 Kids this Christmas. Hold on.
First my hat and not my Bible too.
1 Timothy 4:12. It says, don't let anyone look down on you because of your youth, but set an example for believers in speech, in conduct, in faith, in love, and purity.
Yes, you have purpose, C3 Kids. God moves through us adults, but he wants to move through you too. There is no junior Holy Spirit.
Oh, whoa. Hey, you found my hat.
I did? I just saw it before and I just put it on.
Yeah, it's my hat. It's a Christmas miracle.
Hey, do you guys still feel sad?
Nope, I feel great.
Oh yeah. Now I know that God has a purpose for my life. And I have my hat.
Can we pray?
Of course. Can I pray?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can I have your hat?
Yeah. Oh, wait a second.
My Can hat. I have your hair?
Yeah. Do you want my hair?
Yeah.
Here, take it.
Oh. Wow. You look great.
We love you so much. We thank you that we can have fun, we can have a party, and that you have an expandable table for all of your kids, God, not just adults, but through kids as well, God. So we pray for today, we pray for this Christmas season, that today the kids experience your love. They experience how much they are loved by you, God, and that they receive you in their hearts, and that they know that they are forever chosen, forever loved, that they have a place at your table forever and always, God. So we just pray and believe this for all of our C3 kids and all of our families, that there's unity at the table tonight, God. There's unity in the families through this prayer, and we're just praying and believing that for all the families, everyone watching this, God. So we love you. We thank you for coming to earth and being born.
Yeah.
We thank you for the ultimate gift that's found in Jesus Christ. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for salvation found in you. And we love you, God. Thank you for loving us every single day. We pray all of this in your name. Amen.
Amen. C3 Kids, know that all of us are praying for you every day. God is going to move through you.
Yeah. Do you guys remember we talked about the fruits of the Spirit? God can bring good fruit out of your life. We believe that we will see some pretty cool things happen in your lives.
Have a great day, C3 Kids.
Ho, ho, ho.
Bye.
Merry Christmas. Let's all go dance with Hannah, guys. Let's all go dance with Hannah.
Hey, hey.